I've got the main circuit board out of here. I just took out the four screws. I wanted to try to leave these spade terminals in place because they're really tight, and I'm just kind of afraid of damaging something because you really have to pull hard. You can't really get any access to these terminals, so it turns out if you just kind of lift this up here, and you got to keep those little wires out of the way and get these transformer wires here out of the way, you can just get that out past the fan and then flip it over, and there's the bottom side of the board. And this capacitor should be really easy to change. It blew the solder joints right out of it. I think that capacitor will come right out of there. Blew the bottom of it right out of there. So LH Nova. I couldn't see the brand on there. I'm not sure if that's a real high quality capacitor. I imagine Tripp-Lite uses pretty decent caps. There you can kind of see the where the capacitor was, just blew out the bottom. There's plus over on that side. Looks like you're minus. I'll assume the other two are the same way. I'll check them when I pull them out, but they do seem to have the silk screening pretty good there. So this is the fuse, 12 volt fuse coming in. So this is your positive side of the H bridge, and then you have 5 to one side, 5 to the other side, and then over here you've got your red and black going to the transformer, and you've got 5 MOSFETs here and 5 over here. So I've been checking out the MOSFETs here. They use the IRF-3205 rated at 55 volts, 110 amps. And they have 5 in parallel, so that would be like 550 amps total. And the surge current on this 12-volt, 1,000-watt inverter, I've seen upwards of 200 amps. That's pretty reasonable. They're running about 40 amps per MOSFET at peak current. So, you know, that seems to be fairly well rated. And I think all the MOSFETs are okay. So what I've done is gone down the line here. I believe the middle pin on these, you've got gate, drain, source, and the drain is tied to the body. So if I come up here on the heat sink, which is tied to all the bodies, and I measure to the source, I'm getting roughly 10K, and I measured the same thing on all 10 of these. So this is the other side. This is your positive input. And if I do the same thing here, I'm getting, you can see that, about 5 megs. And all 10 MOSFETs measure out at 5 megohms. So I think everything's good. I don't see anything shorted. Okay, got the capacitors out. And these are the other two. And they both had one leg blown off right at the base, and if you go in and probe that, so I'm on resistance here, and get in on that, 0. So that one's a dead short, and this one is the same. Get in there, 0. So what I did was I pulled all the heat sinks off of here because I needed to get access to the capacitor locations. There were some of the leads from the old capacitors, and so the leads were still stuck in the plated through holes. I got my soldering iron here and went on to the back and heated up the solder, pushed the lead through so I could grab it from the front side here, and then I was able to use the soldering iron on this side and grab the end of the lead with a pair of wire cutters and pull those out. And then I basically did the same thing with my solder sucker. So you just get the soldering iron on the pad, put the solder sucker over the top of the hole here, let it heat up for a little bit, and then suck out the solder. So I've got all 6 holes are clear now, so I can see daylight through there. I wasn't able to find a lot of information on these LH Nova but they're apparently made in Taiwan. And I found a data sheet here, or kind of a explanation. So these are the radial aluminum electrolytic. And then these, let's see, here we are. They're the LE or M series. And if you come down here, we're low impedance. And the LE and LM are 105C, 4,000 hours. On paper, these are fairly good capacitors. I haven't been able to find much online about the actual quality of these, but I did see one forum where they were talking about these are maybe middle of the road, and the post was saying that any Panasonic or Nishikon or name brand capacitor will be better than these. So the Panasonics I have, which are, let me grab one here. So these are the ones I got. Panasonic, and these were the, these are rated at 105C and 5,000 hours, low ESR. Again, I checked these on my parts checker, and they come out about 0.02 ohms, or about 20 milliohms between these, and the data sheet says they're supposed to be about 18 milliohms, so that checks out. They all check out 3,300 plus or minus a few microfarads, so I think we've got good capacitors, so I'm going to go ahead and put those in. We'll get them glued down, soldered, and then I'll put some new thermal paste on all the transistors, and then we'll screw all those back in. Okay, I've got the capacitors soldered back in, leads trimmed, I've got all the heat sinks back on. Okay, I think we got our back together. I put some aluminum duct tape here over this grill on the negative side, so that should block that off and just allow air in right here where the heat sinks are. So yeah, we've got the board back in, got the power supply fan hooked back up there, ground screw is on, got the negative cables hooked up, and then got the fuse and the positive side hooked up. I got to hook up the control panel, which is on the top of the unit, and then we'll plug it in and see if it powers up. So I'll bring you back when I get this plugged in, and we'll see how it works.